Today's interview is with Jessica Lauria and Karen Pfaff Manganillo. They are the founders of By Karen and Jess, creators of Another Fucking Tote, and other things that people have tons of but always need, such as thank you notes, birthday cards, to-do lists, and so on. We asked, what's your favorite book and why? Business and non-business if possible. To this question, Jessica replied, for business, What to Do When It's Your Turn and It's Always Your Turn by Seth Godin. This book is my professional bible and my key management tool. It dives into our human instinct to make excuses, settle for less, and complain about why we haven't achieved success. But the main idea always rings true, that it is up to us to make change for others and for ourselves. Nothing is stopping you but you. It's a reminder of the awesome power of now, the power of positivity, and just simply the power of showing up and moving forward. I have used it in every management review I give because Seth uses incredible insights to uncover our insecurities and provides clear actions on how to move beyond our immediate issues. It's an inspirational book that is also a step-by-step guide to keep you motivated. For non-business, Catcher in the Rye by J.D. Salinger. It explores great characters during a special time in New York history. I love walking around New York and thinking about how it has evolved and changed over the decades, yet so much of its authenticity remains. To the same question, Karen replied, Business, Tibor by Tibor Kalman. Chip Kidd Book 1 by Chip Kidd. Once Upon a Time by Slim Ahrens. Our True Intent is for Your Delight by Martin Parr. These are a selection of my favorite creative minds who visually inspire me like no one else. For non-business, Time and Again by Jack Finney. I've always had an obsession with New York, past and present. I've probably read this book 10 times. Sex, Drugs and Cocoa Puffs by Chuck Klosterman. Never have I read a book that I said, this is so perfect, amazing, hilarious, he's thinking what I'm thinking in a much more thought out and cool way. We asked Jessica and Karen, was there a moment specifically when something you read in a book helped you? Can you tell us about it? Jessica replied, You Are a Badass, How to Stop Doubting Your Greatness and Start Living an Awesome Life by Jen Sincero. I bought this book because I was curious about the title. I loved it and bought it for my entire team. The universe matches the energy you put out. It's so true. If you put out positivity, you get it back. It's a great reminder that you are in charge of your destiny. Another point in this book that I love, if someone has a problem with you, it's their issue, not yours. We put so much weight on what people think about us when it really shouldn't matter. We asked Jessica and Karen, what books had the biggest impact on them? To this question, Jessica replied, Truth, Lies and Advertising, The Art of Account Planning by John Steele. In advertising, you can try to follow a model or data or process, but that will never lead to great, impactful work. Great work comes from the humanity of simple consumer insights and how that comes to life. There is just a little bit of magic that happens when people come together with the same goal to create work that has meaning. I think this is even more relevant in today's data-rich and performance marketing environment. If we lose the consumer's insights and humanity, then the relationship between brands and consumers will just be transactional. We can't lose the art of advertising. To the same question, Karen replied, If You Want to Write by Brenda Uland is undoubtedly the book that changed my way of thinking and opened up my mind to a creative career. It validated being creative, and that is a great thing. We asked, what books would you recommend to youngsters interested in your professional path and why? Jessica told us, Purple Cow by Seth Godin. If you are going into advertising and marketing, remember that you want to make an impact in the world and not just be another mediocre brand. Our next question was, how do you make time for reading? Karen replied, It's hard, but I do what I can. But what I'm mostly proud of currently is instilling a 2-book bedtime routine with my 4-year-old. After 3 years of the schedule, he can quote every book in his library. We also asked, how do you choose what books to read next? And Karen told us, I'm lucky to have best friends who have better literary tastes and time to read than me. I followed their recos without question. Our next question was exclusively for Jessica. Jessica, we know that you were part of Seth Godin's Alt MBA program. From the books that you had as recommended reading, which one had the biggest impact on you? And how did you apply in your life the lessons you learned from it? Jessica said, The Art of War, Winning the Inner Creative Battle by Stephen Pressfield. I love this book. It simply lays out the difference between the true artist and the amateur. It is so inspiring and makes you understand if you are doing something because of a real passion or just passing the time. It also makes you realize that true success is never an accident. Start with Why, How Great Leaders Inspire Everyone to Take Action, by Simon Sinek. It's amazing how many companies exist without even knowing their why. It's what we are always trying to uncover for clients in advertising and as a brand, something we always are trying to answer. Understanding the why gives you purpose so you know what you are striving for every day. Our last question for Jessica and Karen was, what book are you currently reading and what are you expecting to gain from it? To this question, Jessica replied, well, I just had a baby a few months ago, so my world is being dominated with all things baby. I'm currently reading Bringing Up Baby by Pamela Druckerman, an American journalist who raised her family in Paris and dives into the psychology of French parenting. It's fascinating and only reinforces how neurotic American parents can be. Great to hear all sides and theories on raising children, so you take bits from here and there to create your own style, just right for you and your family. To the same question, Karen replied, I just bought the Environmental Protection Agency brand standard systems on Kickstarter. It's probably the most complex and well-rounding brand guidelines manual I've ever seen, and from a graphic designer, truly amazing. As someone who's frequently creating brand guidelines, this book will be invaluable as a reference guide in the future. This was our interview with Jessica Lauria and Karen Pfaff Manganillo. If you want to find out more about their project, visit anotherfuckingtote.com. You can find all the books mentioned in this interview by clicking the link in the video description. The CEOlibrary.com is a daily updated library of book recommendations and interviews from the business people we look up to. Thank you!